Alright,
Yahweh Kanan, Ban Yahweh Da, Ban Yasha. Shalom, today's motivation is, what is the importance of the name?
Now I see why Nick got rid of the name. This Luke 9:49. I got to give you this. This Luke 9:49. And John answered and said, Master, we saw one casting out devils in thou name. So for you to even have the spirit and power of Yahweh Shah, you gotta have that name. IUIC, they understand this. They understand this. When he was the super Gadite, when he broke the name down in an hour plus lesson, it was an excellent lesson. And we forbid him, because he followed not with us. And Yahweh Shah said unto him, forbid him not. For he that is not against us is for us. So the elites understand that you have to get rid of that name. You keep the doctrine, y'all can be Israelites, you can be Judah, and all that, but don't know Yahweh Shah. And it came to pass when the time was come that he should be, that's it on that. Acts 4:12. See, because what's happening today happened in the past to the apostles too. This Acts 4 and 12. Acts 4 and 12. Neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. So for you to have your salvation, you have to know Yahweh Shah. Period. Because Yahweh Shah got an image, he got a look, he got certain characteristics, he gave you certain commandments, judgments and statutes that you must carry out, like being outside on the highways and byways, whether it's raining, sleet, or snow. Can't be lukewarm, and there's 613 laws that come with this too, like the Day of Atonement. Now when they saw the boldness of Peter and John and perceived that they were unlearned and ignorant men, which is what they consider us today, they marveled and they took knowledge of them that they had been with Yahweh Shah. And today, a lot of y'all watching our videos, you behind the scene people, whether you of our nation or the elites, like the apostle said, that we know the elites is watching our channels. And beholding the man which was healed standing with them, they could say nothing against it. And when y'all actually watch our videos and y'all see us break these scriptures down, y'all can't say nothing against us. That's why that RFID chip, other Israelite groups, y'all being real quiet on it, and that's why people like Zabak and so forth ain't got nothing to say, and he already tapped out. But when they had commanded them to go aside out of the council, they confirmed among themselves, saying, what shall we do to these men? For that indeed a notable miracle has been done by them is manifest to all them that dwell in Jerusalem, and we cannot deny it. And us pushing through the Europe in the storm on the internet, y'all cannot deny that the apostles is men of the Lord and up under them, and those who teach the same name, Yahweh Shah, and the same doctrine. So y'all seeing the 12,000 out of each tribe being sealed and coming back under the house of David, not Saul. Saying, what shall we do to these men? For that indeed a noble miracle has been done by them, is manifest to all them that dwell in Jerusalem, and we cannot deny it. But that it spread no farther among the people, let us straightly threaten them that they speak herefore to no man in this name. It's always about the name. So for y'all to say, well, y'all making a doctrine out of the name, you goddamn right. The name is the doctrine, because the doctrine is Yahweh Shah. See that? Use your own goddamn words against you, boy. Man, look, that's how you know you niggas slow. Okay, I got one more. This John 11:45. And see, this the one y'all hate right here. And this for Nate right here. Because this what he on. Detective Nathaniel. This John 11. Yeah, 11:45. Then many of the Jews which came to Mary and had seen the things which Yahweh Shah did believed on him. But some of them went their way to the Pharisees and told them what thing Yahweh Shah had done. Then gathered the chief priests and the Pharisees a council and said, what do we? For this man does many miracles. if we let him thus alone, all men will believe on him, and the Romans shall come and take away both our place and nation. So y'all like being African-Americans, Israelite African-American, or westernized Israelites. That's why y'all doing rap videos. That's why y'all going out and flying all over the world to heap up disciples to yourself, which the scripture speaks against that. So you have to know that name. You have to be on the Yahushua, not Ahaya Ashaya, not Allah, not Isu, not Jesus, not, what is his name? Damn, I'm trying to think of Jehovah, right? Yeshaya, ain't none of the names gonna save you. It's only one name, one doctrine, one truth, and one set of men who have the truth, which is the apostles, and it's being shown every day. So with that, Shalom. All
right,
what is basically, Akim, what is the significance of knowing the name Yahweh Shah?
Okay, the significance of knowing the name is, the scriptures ask you that question, really. So this is Proverbs 34. It says, who hath ascended up into heaven or descended? Who hath gathered the wind in his fist? Who hath bound the waters in a garment? Who hath established all the ends of the earth? What is his name and what is his son's name that thou canst tell? So the scripture is telling you, asking you, well, whoever performed all these miracles, can you put a name to that? And those names is Yahweh, which is the Father, and Yahweh is the Son. Okay, it says, what is his name, what is his son's name, is thou can tell. So, reading that scripture, you should be able to know and identify that some men on this earth has to have that name, okay? That name is also for salvation, you know? The scripture tell you whoever believes in Yahweh should never perish. So you have to know that name, okay? So this is John 17:6. It says, I have manifested thy name unto the men which thou gavest me out of the world. So Yahweh himself told you that he manifested his name unto the men of the Lord. I have manifested thy name unto the men which thou gavest me out of the world. Thine they were, and thou gavest them me, and they have kept thy word. So the men of the Lord who knows that name, they're going to keep pushing the word. We're not selling how it's about it. They're going to keep proclaiming that name. Okay? Through the spirit of Yahweh Shah. So that's the importance, because the Lord gave them his name. Okay? It says, now they have known all. So like it says, now they that know that all things whatsoever thou givest me are of thee. So part of the spirit of Yahweh Shah that he gave unto his prophets, his servants, is his name, okay? Now let me jump and go to Hebrews 2:12. Yo, I'm gonna start with verse 10. The point is in 12 though. This is Hebrews 2:10. For it became him for whom are all things, and by whom are all things, and bringing many sons unto glory, and the glory is the kingdom. To make the captain of their salvation perfect through sufferings. Okay? For both he that sanctifieth and they who are sanctified are all of one. For which cause he is not ashamed to call them brethren, saying, I will declare thy name unto my brethren. In the midst of the church will I sing praise unto thee. So the Lord said he's going to declare that name. Okay? He's going to declare the name unto the brethren. So the scripture, I believe it's in Matthew, but it said, who are my father, who are my mother? Those that do this work. So the ones who kept that name, the ones who doing that work, those are the ones who's going to give deliverance, you know? And I got one more. Because all throughout the scripture, it tells you that, you know, about this name. You're supposed to know the name, okay? And Ezra's, I'm going to start from verse 44. 2 Ezra 12:44. So I asked the angel and said, sir, what are these? He answered and said unto me, these be they that put off the mortal clothing and put on the immortal clothing. And the immortal clothing
mortal clothing is talking about this flesh, okay? So when we get put in that immortal, let's talk about when the men of the Lord, the 144,000 elect, are going to be beamed up. Okay, they're going to be, this is the part where Yahushua asks to get the crowns, okay? And a part of that mortal and immortal as well is talking about this world, okay? It says, and have confessed the name of the Most High. Now are they crowned and receive souls. So it said, and have confessed the name of the Most High. So what is the name of the Lord? It goes back to Proverbs 34 when it said, what is his name and what is his son's name? Now it's going to tell. It's like it. That's the importance, because the name is what's going to give us salvation. Okay? Then said unto the angel, what young person is this that crowneth them and giveth them palms in their hands? And he said and said unto me, it is the Son of the Most High, Yahusha, whom they have confessed in the world. Then began I greatly to commend them that stood so stiffly for the name of the Lord. So you have to stand stiffly for the name of the Lord in order to get that kingdom in. You can't be calling him Jesus Christ. You can't be calling him Yeshua, Jehovah, Yeshaya, Yahaya, whatever the fuck Jesus is saying. Okay? You can't call him just God. Okay? His name is Yahusha. So that's the importance of knowing his name. That's why, going back to Proverbs 34, it said, what is his name? What is his son's name? If thou canst tell. John 17:7 told you that he's going to manifest that name unto his men. Hebrews 2:12 tell you that the ones who's going to receive that name are the ones who suffered and are his brother. So that name is important. And then I just read the second Ezra, it told you that the one that's still so stiff for the name is the one that's going to be crowned. Okay? So with that, this is my motivation on the name. Why is it important? Because this is the name that's going to get us out of Babylon, aka America. So with that, shalom.